Dear friends of table tennis, welcome once again in Schwechat and welcome to the first final of this last day at the Liga 2013 European Championships. We have the women's double for you, and in this doubles final there will be two teams from Germany. Introducing the first pairing is JP Barthel and Shan Xiana. Their opponents, Petrissa Zoya and Sabine Ditter. The opponent from the Netherlands is Ina Vikat. And from Serbia, Ivo Cerovnik. Excuse me, a little mistake has been made. The umpire Cerovnik is from Slovenia, not from Serbia.
Let's see those, where are the fans from Germany? Wo sind die Fans aus Deutschland? Wir können euch noch nicht hören.
Good afternoon, sports fans, and a warm welcome to the final day of the European Championships here in Schwechat, Austria. This one is the first final of the afternoon, first of four finals as well, and it will be an all-German affair. Patrissa Zoya and Sabine Winter against JP Barthel and Xiana Shan. This is the first time ever that an all One Nation final has taken place in this women's doubles event, and it's the first time that it has been Germany as well. The silver and gold medals are in the bag for Germany. The question is, which way will they be going? Will they be going to the two youngsters playing in light grey and black, or will it go to the two older and experienced players, Shan and Barthel, playing in green and black? It has been a great tournament so far for the Germans. These will be medals number 99 and 100 for them. is the best tournament in a long, long time. Best results in 55 years as they head into this final day with a guaranteed 8 medals and 3 titles. It could also be 5 titles if the singles go their way as well. And the first point goes to Sonia and Winter. Very good points from Bartel and Shan this time, 2-1 for them. And so after the opening 4 points, it is a 3-1 lead for the team in green. Winter and Soli will not be too worried about starting slowly in this match. They were 3-1 down yesterday in their semi-final as Wild went on to win that one 4-3 against Ekholm and Dvorak. Opening 6 points, 5-1 for Shan and Bartel. The second point on the board for Solia and Winter. And these two teams have met each other before. They played in the final of the German Championships earlier on this year in Bamberg. Victory went to Solia and Winter in that one. They also came back from a 3-1 deficit to win that final. Much better point this time from Solia, the left-handed player. And this time, Zhenki Batan going in for the kill. Doesn't take the points, so the lead now just 2 points. Joanna Shan, of course, playing here for the chance to get a medal in every competition. She'll be playing in the singles later on as well at 5 p.m. Again, Winter getting her full body around that one. Just look at the replay, right on the ground, and then a second time as well. Fantastic shot from Sabina Winter. And an excellent shot from Solia as well. They make it 8-8, 6-3 it was for Bartel and Shan, now 8-8. Again, Bartel going in there to take that shot. Should really have been 10-8. She knows it as well. Winter once again on the ground, but she doesn't need to get to that shot. 10-9 a score, so game point for the German youngsters here in the opening game. And Winter again trying to get her full body around that one. Doesn't come off this time. Game point saved by Bartel and Shant. 10-10. First team to lead by two here will take this opening game of the doubles final. And that one, a carbon copy of the earlier point. Winter unable to get any contact onto it. Game point number one for Shant and Bartel. And there it is. The opening game goes to the team in green. Bartel and Shan taking it 12-10. A game point there for Solya and Winter, which they didn't take. But still a long, long time to go in this match. The pair of Winter and Solya are used to being behind, and they will not be fazed by this opening game defeat. And the opening point in the second game goes to Shan and Bartel. And we saw their concerned look on the face of Patricia Solya. She doesn't like losing. Seen here from the early phases that this one will be a very tight match, 2-2 after 4 points in the second game, 1-0 for Bartel and Shan at the moment. And Shan making no mistakes there. She will be playing in the final later on at 5 p.m. Should be taking on Fenley of Sweden in that women's final. Yeah. So 6 points played, 3 apiece as both teams have a little break here. And a very good rally, and the point goes to the Germans in green to Bartel and Shan, 4-3 the lead. When Winter was asked yesterday how she felt about getting into this final, and her only words were, "It's really cool." And I'm sure she'll be saying how cool it is as well to win the gold medal. Excellent shot from Solia. Bartel and Shan on the end of an excellent shot from Solia. 5-5 after 10 points. And that was an unfortunate bounce for Solia and Winter there. Nothing really they could do, apart from watch that one slip out of their hands. So 6-6 after 12 points. And things very, very even in game number two. Both teams trading point for point, 7-7. Solia and Winter are the German national champions at doubles level, beating these two in the final in Bamberg this year. They've played each other twice in recent times, and Winter and Solia have been the victors. Things not going Winter's way at the moment. Saw the reaction there after that point as well. 9-7 the score in favour of Bartel and Shan. So 3 game points for Shan and Bartel for them to take a 2-0 lead. Getting a little fortunate there with that point. No trainers, of course, here in this match, as it is an all-German final, the first time ever that a final has been held with just one nationality. And that's a second game point saved. Very good play from Winter and Solia this time. 9-10 now the score. Wasn't what Patricia Solia needed there. Service error after saving 2 game points, and now find themselves 2-0 down here against Bartel and Shan. And they have the work cut out for them, but it's not a position that they're strangers to. They were trailing 3-1 yesterday in the semi-final, and also in that final of the European, of the national doubles event, they were also trailing 3-1 against Bartel and Shant, and they went on to win that final as well. They do enjoy being put under pressure against Zoch and Hidachi in the earlier rounds as well. They were 3-1 down and went on to win it, so still a long, long way to go in this one, and Solia and Winter will not be too phased with how things have gone so far. So very important for Solia and Winter that they do win this game. They can't afford to go 3-0 down against Shan and Bartel. First point does go to the team in light grey and black. However, that one's skying out of the arena from Winter. So best start so far in a game for Solia and Winter, 3-1. They lead after the opening 4 points. And an excellent forehand from Winter as well, 4-1 now the score in their favour. Again, this time though, just taking the slightest of touches off the net, allowing Winter to win that point. So much better third game here from Solia and Winter. They lead 6-1. And a very nicely placed shot from the number 526 this time as well. Just didn't need to get a lot of power on that one, just placing it as far away as possible from her opponent. So a 7-point advantage here for Solia and Winter. Eight. 10 points played, 8-2 in favour of the two young Germans. Just sense here that the support and the fans are definitely behind Solia and Winter, behind the two youngsters. 9-3 they lead. So 7 game points here for Solia and Winter to make this one 2-1. 4. And there it is, second attempt taken, 11-4. Much better third game there from Solia and Winter. 2-1 now the score, and that was exactly the reaction they needed in that game. They were unlucky in the second one. Really had to show a lot of character in the third game as well to show that they're not going to be beaten easily here by Shan and Zhenqi Bartel. So we have a big game on our hands now, and don't forget we have plenty more top quality table tennis action in store today. At 4 p.m. the men's final between Dmitry Ovcharov and Vladimir Samsonov. You can't really get better than that in the men's singles, it has to be said. The number one seed against the number two seed. And then at 5 p.m. Fenley of Sweden against Jona Shan of Germany. And then it will be concluded at 6 p.m. Gardos Harbison against Tan and Wang in the men's doubles. And Winter winning that point this time, 2-1, the score in favour of her and Solia. And just like in the third game, the two German youngsters take a 3-1 lead after the opening 4 points. Points played, 3 apiece. Winter to serve. Ooh, and that one taking the full force of the net as Shan and Bartel take a 4-3 lead. So a timeout has been called by Solia and Winter. They won't have anyone to talk to in the corner though. There are no coaches when the same nation plays against each other. And there is Gschopp there, the German national coach, watching on from the stands. And of course she'll be very, very proud at the fact that the Germans have written history here. The very first time that one nation has been in the final of the women's doubles. And it just so happens to be Germany, looking to clean up here in medals. They won the gold in the women's and men's team events. There will be a gold here in the doubles as well, and there may well be a gold in the singles of the men's and women's event as well. And again, Sodia not having the look of the net. Things not going their way at the moment. This time again, that slight touch off the net, enough to make it very difficult for Sodia to return that shot. 6-3 the score. Oh, and this time Sodia placing that shot as far in the corner as it would go, and Bartel running after it without a hope. Perfect shot from Sonia. Points in a row get the young German pair right back into this game. And Winter saw the chance and took that one as well. Two very good shots from her to make it 6-6 after 12 points. And Bartel completely mishitting that one, so the younger German pair take a 7-6 lead. And so that run comes to an end on 4 points, as the two teams are now level on 7-7. Similar situation in the second game as well. The more experienced German pair in green went on to win that one 11-9. So a slight delay there as Vinky Bartel has to go fetch that ball. 8-7, she leads alongside her teammate Sean. And once again, this one developing into a very, very tight match. 8-8. And Sonia now with a touch of cramp, and this is not good for her. Not moving too comfortably out there on the table at the minute, Patricia Sonia. And she looks a little concerned, Patricia Sonia, out there on the table. Touch of cramp, also hasn't had the best of luck from with her shots either. 9-8, the score in favour of the team in green. And she got perhaps a little fortunate there with that backhand. I'm not sure Bartel expected to be on the end of that one. Again, nicely placed in the corner. And this time it is Bartel and Shan who call a timeout. 9-9 the score after 18 points. 6-3 was the lead for the team in green earlier on in this game. It was then 7-6 for Winter and Sonia, and now 9-9. And Sonia having a word with the physio. Looks like she's either got a bit of cramp or might have tweaked a muscle. I think it is probably just cramp, maybe not warming up well enough. She is able to smile. She should be able to continue in this match. Already saw one very serious injury as Carlsen broke a bone in his foot earlier on Friday, I think it was, in the doubles event. They were the number two favorites, and their campaign ended with a broken bone. Point goes to the young German pair, 10-9. They have one game point. Solja will serve. In the second game, she had a service error at a very crucial point. Oh, and they haven't taken a game point again in the opening game. They wasted an opportunity as well, and it went on to haunt them. They don't want to go 3-1 down against Bartel and Shan now. And so, a second attempt here, second bite at the cherry to take this one to 2-2. It's all down to Solja. She had to really scutter across the table to get to that one. It was a very good shot as well. 12-10, so 2-2, and it's a real game on our hands now in this women's doubles final. It's exactly what we wanted as well. 2-2 between Solja and Winter and Bartel and Shan. You see once again, very good movement from Solja to get to that point, and from being 2-0 down, it's now 2-2 in this women's doubles final. Oh, and what a shot there from Winter. She does enjoy going to ground. And she certainly went as low as could go there. Almost doing a complete roll back on her feet very quickly as well. Great agility there from Sabina Winter. And so after 33 minutes in this match, it's 2-2 in game number 5, 2-2 in games as well. And just since now that the fans are starting to warm to this match, isn't a sellout here on the final day, which is a shame. It has been one of the major talking points over the course of this week, the fact that there are far too many empty seats here in the Werner Schlager Academy. Perhaps it will be a little bit fuller later on for the doubles final, with Harbison and Gardas taking part. Well, things looking very good here for Winter and Solia, and you maybe sense now that that knowledge is starting to creep back into the heads of Bartan and Shan, that they have lost to Winter and Solia before, despite leading. And they know that Solia and Winter are good enough to beat them out there on the table. And after having a 2-0 lead and allowing Solia and Winter to get back into this one, it will surely be having an effect on them. Always going to be difficult there. Solia having to get across the table very quickly as well. Opening up the opportunity for Shan to fire that one down the middle. 7-5 now the score. 2-point advantage has opened up here for Bartel and Shan. Yeah! And that was an important point there. I think the younger German team were in trouble as that rally progressed. Seven-seven. 2 points in a row. Put these two teams on level scores again, just like in game number two and game number four. And this time, venomous, venomous shot. I don't think Winter even saw that one coming. Eight, eight. You can tell there by the reaction from the fans that Winter and Solia are the fan favourites in this one. So 9-8 in favour of the team in green. They will perhaps be a bit disappointed at the fact that they don't have the crowd on their side. The two youngsters, Solia and Winter, definitely the fan favourites here in Schwerkart. Well, that was a very good point. 9-9, and once again we're going to head to a very exciting final few points here. Solia and Winter having a very serious discussion out there on the sideline, discussing the tactics for the next 2 points, perhaps. And Winter has slowly been told off there for taking too long as well. And a yellow card shown to the Germans. And that will not trouble them though, as they have game point to take a 3-0 lead. They have to be careful though, they have been taking a lot of time between points. And that's why they've got the yellow card. Yeah! Oh, and an excellent return from the serve, and Winter and Solly are taking a 3-2 lead here. They've come back from 2-0 down to lead 3-2, and they are one game away from European gold here in the doubles. Fantastic doubles action so far. 2-0 was the score after the opening two games, 12-10, 11-9 in favour of Zdenko Bartel and Jonas Schan. And then a very convincing third game, 11-4 for Solly and Winter, gave them a lifeline in the match. And 12-10, 11-9, I mean they now lead 3-2 and are one game away from European gold here in the doubles. I mentioned earlier, this is by far and away the best tournament so far for Germany. Best result in 55 years as they headed into this final day with a guaranteed 8 medals and 3 titles, including this one. And it could well be 5 titles as well if Shan can win her singles final later on. And if Ovcharov can beat the number 2 seed Samsonov in the men's singles, that one will be at 4 p.m. here on table 1. And this is of course a very important game here for Bartel and Champ. Quick thinking from the young German pair, getting as far behind the table as possible there, but didn't work off for them. Very, very good rally, and Bartel is not happy about losing that one. Both teams giving 100% there. Point advantage opening up for Solia and Winter. Momentum is definitely on their side. Body language from Bartel, not the best at the moment. Yeah! And Shan also finding it difficult with her shots. She needs to be careful that she doesn't let this one get to her too much. She'll be playing at 5 p.m. in the singles event as well. That match against Fenley of Sweden. She will not want to be on the losing side of two finals here on the last day. Yeah! And again, Stan unable to return that one in a 6-3 lead has opened up here for Solia and Winter. A yellow card shown to Bartel and Shant as well. Now both teams on a yellow card. Top. 6-4 after 10 points. Still a 2-point advantage for Winter and Solia. So, the young German pair now 4 points away from European gold. Ooh, and that took the slightest of touches. An apology for Winter, but they will not be too unhappy about taking that point. A touch of the net, and then just the slightest of touches on the edge of the table. 8-4, 3 points needed now for Winter and Solia. Nine-four. Plenty of players watching on the sidelines as well. One of them is Bernadette Zotz, who won youth European gold in the doubles with Patricia Solia. And I'm sure she would be hoping that she'll be out there on the table with her now. In any case, it's Sabina Winter out there, 2 points away now from European gold. And here it is, match point for Solia and Winter. They have 6 match points now. One match point saved. They still have 5 more left to play for. Need to make sure that they don't let the nerves get to them. Big, big moment here for Solia and Winter. Oh, another one saved. 10-6. Congratulations to them. A wonderful performance. They came back from being 2-0 down to take a 4-2 victory against Shan and Bartel. Wonderful scene here for the two youngsters, the fan favourites. They win it in the end. 10-12, 9-11, 11-4, 12-10, 11-9 and 11-6. And they have the gold medal, another gold medal for Germany and another medal for Solia. She now has gold in the team and in the doubles. Commiserations to Zdenka Bartel and Joanna Shan. Joanna Shan still has one opportunity left to get a gold, and that will be in the women's singles at 1700, and she takes on Fenley. And so she needs to make sure she didn't let that get to her. The next match on table one is Dmitry Ovcharov against Vladimir Samsonov.